So, good morning. Today I will talk about homework and summer chores. So, I'm going to start by talking about what is our job as parents. The first and most important thing is to make sure our kids are happy and have them well fed and having a place to study. Having nice books and nice games available for them. I think it's not so important to focus just on study time because we look at our kids as individuals. So the fact that we are not fluent in Japanese, this is a really hard language, I understand. Sometimes is maybe not so important. The important thing is to focus on the overall of their education. There are many types of study. So if we focus on several things, it's not the language learning is not only what they study in school that is important. Yes. I have here a chart that we can see, and I will show it to you about several types of learning. Okay. So we have here visual, auditory, read and writing, and the kinesthetic. Okay, so here by this you can already see that is not only I can give you this chart later on, is not only the things that they learn in school that matters. There are many things beyond that, and we as parents, if we concentrate in the other parts, that is their curriculum, their mental health, how much they are resting, if they are drinking enough water, communication skills, survivor skills, mindfulness, and especially having fun. This is a very important part of their education. Then we can totally hire a tutor for covering the parts that we are not so good at. So one important thing is to set goals together, to talk about the future with your child, and to sit down and say, what do you want to be, or what are your goals, or what do you aspire for, what subject do you like the most? Yes, and identify the why are we studying, and this will give them a goal. This will give them how to set up a new insight for their future life. Yes, I think mind games, manipulations, this never works or works at a very short period, during a very short period, and after that never works. What works better is really to focus on their education, on the real level, on an inner level. If they are happy, if they are fulfilled, when they feel the love and attention from their family, this is the basic thing. So this is mainly our jobs. Yes. And then the study will come up with the several types of study that we can integrate, and depending on their level of maturity. Okay. I think it is important that the parents don't limit themselves because I can't. I don't know Japanese. I'm not a native Japanese. I can't help my child in studies. No, it's not like that. you as a parent have a much more important role to set up grounds for the study. And after that, I'm sure everything will be okay, yes? Helping your child to focus on what is important is the main thing. About the study in Japan, let's say that it demands much more planning than I usually see on the parents that try to compete with the Japanese parents in school, because the school is a little bit competitive. I understand about that. We would like things not to be like that, but they are like that. So let's face it with the tone of reality. Yes. So one thing that we as parents living in Japan and having our child in the Japanese school is set your child for success and for learning and for being in pair with the other kids that are his Japanese peers or colleagues and that are on the same grounds. I think for Japanese professionals, for Japanese teachers, the fact that your child is not from a Japanese family, this has nothing to do. I think they will, knowing the Japanese culture, I think they will think that you have the same grounds for succeeding in learning Japanese, putting your child to have good grades in Japanese also. So I think teaching our kids to challenge themselves in whatever language is our main role, to set up their minds to challenge and to overcome the difficulties that will arise. And see this, if we can educate them to see this and to face this with positivity, it's great. I think it's fantastic. So I think for organizing and planning is the main thing that will set us up to have a good success in studying the Japanese language while the kids are studying in the Japanese school. Yes. So for the summer vacation schedule, from the day one, from the time they receive their schedule and their homework in school, let's start setting up a schedule for this day. Yeah, so let's see how many pages your kid has to study. So let's divide this by the number of days that we have, vacation days that we have, and we can know how many hours we will have to study. This is different for the three different levels, yes, for Shogaku, for high school and for elementary school is all different, the three stages. So be aware of that and adapt this to your child. In this schedule, you have to count on their free time and you have to count also with their study time, their free time for study, their feeding time, count with all of that, okay? And it is important that the goals are real. It's better to start real and to try to achieve more goals with time, yes, step by step. I will show you another. I was stealing some graphics from Pinterest, so I can show you here. Okay. So how much sleep does your child need? Depends on their age, yes? For a newborn is 11 to 19 hours. I think we don't have anyone here in this stage, so let's move on. For example, for toddlers, 9 to 16 hours, and preschool and school age, we have 8 to 12 hours, depending on the kids. Some kids need more rest, other kids need less. Yes, and the other older kids, let's set up the schedule for between 8 and 11 hours per day. So counting on this, and I think resting is one of the most important settings for having them grounded and capable of concentrating during long periods. I think one thing that is really, really important is to set study and reading as an habit, as a good habit, with a certain positivity. I think this point is really important, to have them positively studying and not with this, way that you have to study, go there and study because you need to have this grade. No, it's not like that. Take it easy and don't give up if they don't want to do the homework on that day, if they don't want to do paper study or home worksheets, whatever thing that they have to do for as a homework, try to do something else. You have many tools. We have many tools nowadays. We can learn the same thing with songs or with games or with applications that we can download. Yes? And if we make a good planning, is we can set up goals much more clearly, yes, about the things we have to study with them. And to take advantage of the vacation period, let's say, if your kid doesn't study anything during the vacation period, what will happen? Not only you will lose this precious time for studying and to move ahead on the study curriculum, but also when the school he has to go to the school again, he will be very hard to have the same frequency of study and the attention span. So let's keep on studying during the vacation period, of course, in a more lightly way, but not stopping, not doing nothing is really fatal, yes? So plan according to your kid's age. If you can make clear goals of the things that you want to study during the vacation period, it's much more clear. You can visualize where you will arrive. Yes, what to do during the time of your vacation. For example, you can set up that we will learn things that we couldn't learn during the school period. Yes, we didn't have time to go deeper, or we want to finish something that we didn't finish, a project that wasn't finished, something that was not well set up. Yes, or let's pick up, if we have these already done, then let's accumulate for next year. Yes, we already finished the kanji for first grade. Now let's start with the Ninensei kanji so we are more prepared for the next year. Okay. If your kid already knows the present grade and the next grade, then do a fukushu about everything that he has to do. Yes. And this can include kokugo, kanji, and all the other subjects that he's studying in school. I think planning is really important because the curriculum, the Japanese curriculum, is really long. And if we have, like we have, our family has, two more languages to learn, imagine. We cannot do the best about the three languages. We just try to do the best we can because we cannot have the same native level for the three languages. We can try, and in some moments we can have it, but not 100% of the time. Yes, planning ahead is really important because then we can study and have materials already studied before starting the school year. Helping your child to find his way of study is one of the most important things. Yes, how he can learn by hearing or by studying, by writing, by reading with manga, how it is, how he can learn well. Setting up this as a goal is the most important. To set up the habit of reading and setting up the habit of picking up the materials and the homework by himself. This is our dream, right? We don't have to study. We don't have to sit with them to study. This would be great. Not always is possible because, of course, they want to play and they are, they it's the most important thing. Let's not think that play is not important. It is the most important thing. But we can do play learning based, yes? Communication, when we communicate with them, we know what's going on with them in their, what's their feelings, what are they afraid of, what are things that frustrate them and can stuck them into failure. And this is very frustrating. I think from the things that I see from the parents groups, I think parents have some confidence that their child will catch up. And this is true. The thing is that the other kids are already studying this for much longer. So we need to put our foot down to learn and to make them, and to make them understand that we also have to study. Having the minimum is not enough here for Japanese settings, yes? And we trust that the school will teach everything from the start, will teach hiragana from the start, so my kid is okay. So I will work on English or I will work on Portuguese. But the fact that they feel that they are not paired up with the other kids will give them a sensation of frustration. Yes, and this is the thing that we don't want. So of course it's important to study our minority languages. It's totally important. English and French, whatever language that they don't have access. But at the same time, don't forget that they have to study also Japanese. Yes. If you don't have a Japanese parent or a Japanese close member of the family, you can always hire a tutor, or you can have a friend or that can work. And if you see your family as a team, yes, it's much easier to set up goals and set up this environment. I think creating an habit of study is much easier for them to have, to be used to pick up their books and to pick up their homework. So I think making a schedule make it quite easier. Yes, for example, you wake up in the morning, brush up your teeth and dress yourself and have breakfast, and then let's study and set up a time for doing house chores, because this is also important to help the parents. Yes, check how many modules and divide them by days. If you are studying with your child, I think sitting down on the same table, of course, every family has a different setting, but sitting down with them at the table is a good method, because they see that we are working also, but they are on our side, so they cannot distract much. We are on top of them. And they can see that we are doing something, yes. Start with the things, start your study period by the things that your child likes or already knows. I think this is a little bit easier to start with this. Yes, if they already know, if you start math by a different thing that they don't know, they will feel, I don't want to do this. It's mendoksai, I don't want. Okay, so starting with an easy goal, with an easy thing to do, it's much easier to set them up. If you are the one to prepare the schedule, intercalate the subjects that your child likes with the ones that he doesn't like. Yes, for example, when I was a kid, I didn't like math at all. So I never started with this. I would start with Portuguese because it was my favorite subject. And then I would move, if I had time, I would move on to math or whatever thing that I had to study, because it would open my appetite to start the studying period. Yes, I think after lunch, maybe it's a hard, kind of hard period to put them to study because you had lunchtime, usually you are more sleepy, so be careful with this time, this period. If your child your child still needs your help to study, sit down with him at the table. I think this is not a bad idea. And no ketais, no phones. Try to do something that you can do with the paper-based is better. Yes. And if he wants to give up, says, I'm tired, okay, change to something else. Don't let him escape. Don't let him say no. Don't let him stop. Just let him just take a break. Okay, let's do a game. Okay, let's do a study. Let's study on an app on the computer, for example. Yes. Let's watch some songs or a video or, okay. Set yourself to have contact with people that are on the same setting as you are. It means people that are positive about studying and about Japanese education. People that want their kids to be involved in school projects, in school events. When you look at others and you really see they are successful, their kids are integrated, their kids can play well with the other kids, they have friends, they can study, they have good grades. But this, you just see the top of the mountain, let's say, because behind this, there's effort. Yes, there's effort, there's discipline, there's dreams. So cross your fingers for also you can set up your life like that. But actually, I think if your friends are like that, it's easier for you to also be successful in this point. Yes. One thing that I would have liked someone to tell me, that everything in this life is made of effort. It's all it takes is effort and focus. It's not something that will just come on as, I'm good at this. It doesn't cost me anything. Yes, of course, there's some tendency, natural tendency from some people that, I'm good at drawing. But it always demands some degree of effort. Yes. Okay, some tricks to make your study time better. Yes. Make a schedule with your child, or adapt it to your child in case he is too young to set up the schedule with you. Make it the study period like a game. Let's see if we can do this. And if you can set up your child brain to think that this is like a game, this is the best. Oh, it's so funny to learn. Oh, now I can do this. And this click will make the turn. Yes. Talk about your child's future many times. I would like you to go and do this. What would you like to do? Not only inputting information, but also asking what does he want to do in the future? Yes. And by this, your kid can have a sense of future of what he wants to do. He can see far, because if he's just concentrated in what he is doing right now, it is too small, let's say. So what is the reason we are studying? Is to aspire something in the future, right? Invest in stationery, invest in pencils, nice erasers, notebooks. I think this is so exciting when you have a new notebook and you want to use it, right? Yes. Use different tools, songs, game, books, paper-based worksheets, different things you can find. We have so many things that we can find today on the internet. Yes, it's a great tool. Invest in some books, new books. Okay, so let's set up your study for next year. Let's already buy the books and let's check the curriculum. It's exciting to see what are we going to study next year. Set achievable goals. It means if your goals are too high, your child will feel frustrated and you also, yes? So real goals that you can achieve is better, and then you can maybe expand. Go to museums and go traveling if you can. Now we are in this period with Corona, it's hard to go somewhere, but if you can go to museums, is another way of studying. For example, if you are studying about the let's say the water cycle, you can go to the water museum, or you can this will open their knowledge about many things. Intercept with other activities. For example, English with science. Yes, you want to study, want your kids to study science, for example. You can cross this with the science and English, or for example, your daughter loves makeup. Okay, so you can say, you can check things about makeup on YouTube, but let's check in English. Now let's see what there is, what we can, or by the opposite, in Japanese, yes? Set up rules about phones, especially if your kid is already a teenager, yes? Because sometimes they will go to study, they go to their rooms, and you cannot control what they are doing. They just say, oh, okay, you have to study for half an hour, but you cannot control what they are doing. So if they are studying 30 minutes, let's say, but always checking their case ties and like this, of course, they cannot concentrate well on what they are doing. Set up a study place. I personally am very fond of kitchen table study, because I can do something else in the kitchen. I can be cooking or whatever thing, and my child is studying, and I can check what she's doing and help a little bit. And I'm not on top of her. I just pretend I'm not on top of her, but I'm watching what she's doing. So I think this some control is important. Find a study buddy, a study friend, or a group that your child can join. Yes, I think this is also important, because the closest your child is to someone that is good in what he's studying, the better it is for him, right? Yes. Teach your child to be positive towards school. Will give him or her another vision of about what is school. Is not boring, is not it, this comes much more from your feeling than what what's going on in the school, because if you feel that it's boring, maybe it is, or maybe it is just your feeling that this material to study is boring and is not there, even after you already know all of it, there you can still find things to study, especially for perfectionists. Yes? Focus on your child as a being and not only on grades. Your child is not the grades. Your child is a person. So the whole thing, I think, is really, really, really important if he's mentally healthy. Yes? If he can sleep well, if he has friends in all patterns of his life. Okay, now let's move on to the house chores. Yes, and actually is the same. It's about setting up a schedule and following this schedule the best we can. There are many types of schedules. Yes, you can find many, many schedules on the internet, on Pinterest, on Facebook, from several blogs and places. So we have a lot of information. You can set up for kids. There are some, let me see if I can show you, age appropriate chores for kids. Yes, here we can see 2 to 3 years old and what they can do in each age range. Okay, you can see these. I will share these afterwards. For elementary, they can, that is the age that we have many parents joining our groups, is sweep the floor, fold their laundry, wipe counters and tables, yes, vacuum. And if they are used to do this, it's the same as studying. From tender ages, from small ages, is much easier to have them keep on doing. Okay, tricks we can use to make them study, to make them do the house chore with us. Try to make it like a game, the same as before. Yes, who can keep up? Who can pick up more toys in 30 minutes? And you count 1, 2, and get a basket for each one of the kids and help and ask them to pick up the toys. Rewards. I'm not very fond of rewards because they might get used to rewards and then only work for rewards. But well, if you are really desperate, it's okay to use. Set up an envelope, you can put money or stickers and give them this reward if they did the chore. Things, I think kids have a time that they really want to join us when we do our chores. And after that age range is over, it's hard to catch them to ask their help to do something in the house, right? So starting early is really important about the house chores also, yes. But they can start by doing some things like cutting vegetables with your help, of course. Be careful with the knives. Watering the plant or wiping the dishes or the counters. It's really easy tasks and they can start with that. Other tricks. Put the divisions of your house, for example, dining, kitchen, room, parents' room, in a plastic bag and ask them to pick up a paper. And this is the part of the house they have to clean. and set up a timer and let's check who is the fast, who is the fastest. Yes. Use songs, use music when you set up this schedule for cleaning. Why not put really loud music and everybody cleans? It's a really nice method. Another nice game is I Spy, okay? And you just sit in the living room and tell, oh, I spy a stinky sock. And they have to pick up, they have to discover the stinky sock. I spy, oh, there's a doll on the floor, and they have to pick up that doll. I spy a not made up bed, a messy bed, and they have to clean up the bed. Yes. Another nice game to do house chores. Dress up yourself with, for example, an Halloween costume, and let's clean, dress like that. Maybe you will have to find more games because after a while our kids get really bored with these games. Okay, I think I talked enough about all these methods, about all these things, about summer vacation and house chores. I'm sure you can find lots of ideas if you search for. For today, I think I could open your appetite to make a really good job and to inspire you. Okay, so I'll see you next time. Bye bye.